Well, welcome back again. Now, module one, as we said, is all about you. So we're continuing down this pathway. And in lesson three, we're going to forward into innovation. Now, in lesson two, we covered action and we talked about being out of the box. We've talked about your focus in lesson one. And really now we want to step into another arena where innovation is very, very important for you. So again, what we're going to show you here in this lesson is we're going to show you about creating a counterintuitive opportunities for yourself, stop the avoidance, break rules, think like Einstein, okay? But also read, solve, and adjust. And these things are all going to come into the portions of innovation. Now, I want you to understand something, that in our society, everybody competes. But what we really got in competition is a zero-sum game. So what happens is that everybody is playing a zero-sum game. Now, if you're in sales, you're in profession, even if you're in a so-called job career field where you have to move up the ladder, competition seems to be the factor that everybody's going after, all right? But there's not enough creation. There's not enough ability for people to understand we're not competing. It's not a zero-sum game. We're living in abundance. We have plenty to go around. So what we need to do is to get away from competition and start to create. Sure, you're always going to compete with a business that's down the block from you. You're going to compete with maybe the person in the desk next to you in a sense. But really, if you're on the same team, does it make sense for you to be working in an organization competing with the person on your left or competing with the person on your right? Makes no sense whatsoever, because you people are all going in the same direction. So counterintuitive, going where the puck is going to be, means that you're going to focus more on creation. You're going to focus more on expanding your thinking. You're going to focus on how to make things happen versus how to just follow through on what people tell you to do. You need to be creative and you need to be sort of gung-ho on everything you want to get done, okay? So it starts again with you, and this includes breaking rules. Now, in a very classic book about how to think like Einstein, they talked about breaking rules. Now, I'm not telling you to go out and rob liquor stores, okay? This is not the kind of rules I'm talking about. This is not a legal issue. It's not even moral, and it's not even an ethical issue. It's the rules of discovery. It's the rules of education. It's the rules of thinking. Let's consider it. You were raised in an education society that told you what? Get a job, get an education, work for 40 years, and then collect a gold watch and retire. That's a rule. It's a rule, not because it's a rule, but it's a rule because people made it such. And that sort of sucks in on all your thinking. And it makes you think that way because that's what you were taught. So you need to break rules. You need to break rules for yourself. You need to constantly be in an exploration kind of deal. Okay, so really, it's about awareness and then self-development, self-achievement. It's like having a vessel, okay? If you had a cup of water and you continued to pour more and more and more water, the water would overflow. And some people would say that's bad, that's spillage. It's not. You are that kind of vessel. You need to be filled to overflowing. You're never going to overflow. You can't fill the vessel. But until you've got something in the vessel, you certainly can't help anybody else. And if you can't help anybody else, you can't expand into entrepreneurialism and you can't expand into your world of making an incredible amount of money. Because money's going to come because you're willing to help others. Okay? You create more for others, others will respond. That's a unique value proposition. So you have to be a filled vessel and filling constantly for you to have constant unique value. That's the only way to increase your financial ability. So it comes with reading, remember, repeat, verbalize, discover. These things are a constant cycle that you should be in. Again, it comes back to journaling, because this is where you're going to see where you were and where you are now. Now, as a writer, I've written several books, and here's what I found. The first book I wrote was back maybe 20 years ago. My writing today and who I am today and my thoughts today are far different than they were when I wrote that book 20 years ago. So I could rewrite that book from 20 years ago and rewrite that book and it would be totally different than it was, because I'm in a different place in life. That's what the value of your journaling is all about. So I want you to ask questions, okay? The right questions will develop the right answers. The wrong questions give you incomplete answers. This is one of the biggest problems with people in trying to become financially independent. They ask the wrong questions. You continue to ask the wrong question, you're going to get the wrong answer. You will get an answer, but it won't be proper for what you need. So you need to ask the right question. How are you going to do that? Well, curiosity is how you do it. Okay? Listen, curiosity may kill the cat, but it's certainly not going to hurt your career. So you need to be curious. And in curiosity, you will discover. Because you can't discover unless you're curious. Okay, I don't think Columbus would have found America if he wasn't looking. So Columbus got pretty curious about traveling the seas and came across America. Was it an accident? Maybe. But it's a discovery. And he wouldn't have been there unless he was curious. So this is a big part of you becoming financially independent. This has everything to do with money. Some people say, hey, Carl, what the hell are you talking about? This has nothing to do with money. It has everything to do with money. And the reason is you've never heard this before. No one's talking to you about this. Financial advisors, the people who are out there, financial planners, these people are not talking about these things with you. They're just talking about the base core of money. This is how you attract money. And then you can learn more about what to do with the money, but you need to attract the money. So it's a commitment to excellence. It goes on every single day, every single minute of the day, every hour of the day, 7 days a week, 30 days a month, 365 days a year. It's an ongoing process, and you're never going to be the same. You've watched this now for 5, 6, 7 minutes, whatever it is, and I got to tell you, you're not the same that you were when we started this video. So those 7, 8 minutes, you've already changed. Now, you may not recognize it, but you've changed. You're in a different place. Yeah, I know you say, hey, Carl, I'm still sitting in front of my computer looking at this silly slide. No, you've changed. You have changed the position of where you are at this moment, and that's what it does. It changes momentarily. So you need a commitment to excellence. So it's a constant series of adjustments. This is life, okay? Life is not a one-step-at-a-time place. Life is a journey. Life is a journey, and yes, there are steps along the way. But sometimes you take one step. Sometimes you jump over because you're ready and you take 5 steps. Sometimes you take 20 steps. Sometimes you take a massive leap across an entire gap. But it's a journey. Now, the only way to have this journey is you need to know where you've been, where you are, where you're going. So you need a journal. You've got to reinforce that mindset. You've got to build this into your thought process. And I will tell you a quick story about description. We talked about the first law of psychology, if you remember, right? Okay, the mind expands towards what it's consistently reinforced. This has to do with addictions. This has to do with all kinds of things in life. This is the same with success. The people who are ultimately successful for the longest periods of time are the people who believe they're going to be successful and the people who believe that they are successful continually. Because the mind expands. It's consistently reinforced. But description has a huge amount to do with this, because when you describe, and we did this when I was coaching baseball, we did this with some youngsters, when you describe, you draw pictures in your mind, because we think in pictures. It's what we do. So when you describe something, you reinforce it. You reinforce it in your mind, and you start to take on those behavioral characteristics. So description is really important. So if you want to become wealthy, if you want to have things, it's okay, whatever you want to do. Remember, your burning desire, your passion. Well, if you describe this every day, and you can write it down. You write it in a journal and you read it every day. You just describe it. It'll start to be imprinted on your mind. And because it's imprinted on your mind will send out your abilities to get there. You'll go. You'll move towards what it is you want. Sometimes it'll even happen unconsciously. You just move towards what you want. You get in the right place at the right time. You've heard about that, right? Hey, you know, this was serendipitous. This was accidental. Hey, it's a coincidence. No such thing. People are prepared for coincidence. That's how it happens. So you want to be always prepared. Again, when your focus is clear, your results are assured. Okay? Your focus needs to be counterintuitive. commonly referred to as outside the box. And once again, you need to be laser committed towards innovation, creation, and away from competition. Okay, so that's so much for innovation today. We are going to move forward, and I look forward to you in the next lesson. And certainly, again, it's going to be all about you.